Hello everyone, now we will derive the relation between gamma dash, that is submerged unit weight, specific gravity and Voigt's ratio. We know that submerged unit weight is equal to saturated unit weight minus unit weight of water. Saturated unit weight minus unit weight of water. And we know that saturated weight is equal to G plus E into gamma W divided by 1 plus E. In the previous video, we have derived this relation. Therefore, directly you take gamma saturated is equal to G plus E into gamma W divided by 1 plus E minus of gamma W. Clear? Now, take LCM and solve this. We will get G plus E into gamma W minus gamma W into 1 plus E divided by 1 plus E. Clear? 1 plus E is LCM here. Now solve this. We will get one term G into gamma W plus E into gamma W. Next term minus of gamma W into 1 and gamma W into E, and that is minus. Here the plus E into gamma W cancel and minus E into gamma W cancel, and we will get G minus 1. G into gamma W minus gamma W, and take gamma W common factor, we will get this equation. Submerged unit weight. This is the relation between submerged unit weight, specific gravity and Voigt's ratio. It is very simple derivation. Clear? Okay. The next derivation is derivation of relation between gamma D, bulk unit weight and water content. Gamma D, bulk unit weight and water content. We know that water content is equal to weight of water to the weight of solid. Weight of water to the weight of solid. Now, in this equation, add 1 on LHS side and add 1 on RHS side. Again, if you solve, again we will get the same equation. Now, add 1 on both sides, LHS side as well as RHS side. You will get 1 plus W is equal to weight of water divided by weight of solid plus 1. Now solve this and we will get weight of water plus weight of solid divided by weight of solid, because WD will be the in LCM, will get, and you cross multiply here, you will get weight of water plus weight of solid divided by weight of solid. And we know that weight of water plus weight of solid is indicates the total weight of soil, because the weight of air is very small. Therefore, we are not taking this. The weight of water plus weight of solid is nothing but the total weight of soil. The total weight of soil. Correct? Therefore, you take W here. Total weight divided by weight of solid. 1 plus W is equal to 1 plus W is equal to total weight divided by weight of solid. Therefore, weight of solid is equal to total weight divided by 1 plus W, small w, water content. Don't be confused here. Capital W indicates weight term and small w indicates water content. Clear? Therefore, we will get WD is equal to weight of solid is equal to total weight divided by 1 plus water content. Okay. Next, we know that gamma D is equal to weight of solid divided by total volume, this equation. And in above equation, we have gotten the value of WD. Here, WD value we have got. Correct? Now put this value in this below equation. Here. Put this value here in this below equation. Put this value in this below equation and we will get gamma D is equal to weight, total weight divided by 1 plus W into total volume. And we know that total weight divided by total volume is nothing but bulk unit weight. Therefore, put gamma here. Therefore, gamma D is equal to bulk unit weight divided by 1 plus W. This is the relation between dry density and dry unit weight and bulk unit weight. Next derivation is relation between saturated density, bulk density, dry density and degree of saturation. Saturated density, bulk density, dry density and degree of saturation. We know that bulk unit weight or density, don't be confused here. Sometimes I will use density as density or sometimes I am using unit weight. Just there is a difference between the units and mass consideration here. Clear? Here unit weight is equal to G plus ES into gamma W divided by 1 plus V. This derivation we have taken in our previous video, we have derived this. Now take this equation and divide this equation. First G into gamma W divided by 1 plus E, one term, and again E into S into gamma W divided by 1 plus E, divide into two terms here. Clear? Next we know that G into gamma W divided by 1 plus E is nothing but dry density equation. Dry density equation. Clear? So one term is clear here. Now take S common factor and we will get remaining two terms, E and gamma W. Now in this term add plus G into gamma W and minus G into gamma W. If you solve, again these two terms will cancel and again we will get previous equation. Clear? Now add G into gamma W and plus G into gamma W and minus G into gamma W. Clear? Next we will get same gamma D here and S common here. Now take gamma W common factor between these two terms. Gamma W common factor between these two terms, you will get E plus G into gamma W and minus G into gamma W. And minus G into gamma W, this term. Now separate these two terms, E plus G into gamma W divided by 1 plus E and G into gamma W divided by 1 plus E, these two terms. And we know that E plus G into gamma W divided by 1 plus E is nothing but unit weight of saturated soil. And G into gamma W divided by 1 plus E indicates dry unit weight. Put the value, we'll get one relation. This is the relation between bulk density, dry density, the saturated density and degree of saturation. Or bulk unit weight, dry unit weight, saturated unit weight and degree of saturation. In the next video, we will see some more derivations. Thank you.